So, you want to bag your Honda Brio RS. Hello and welcome to a new video, guys. And today we have a highly anticipated car for release ngayong araw na ito. And we have the owners in front of us. Hello. And of course, it's a Honda Brio. Welcome sa How to Bag Your Honda Brio. It's very similar to Honda Jazz. Right out of the bat, sabihin ko agad sa inyo na under chassis nito ay parehas lang ng Jazz, City, Brio of course, and of course, the Mobilio. This is very prominent sa mga Honda cars na in this eco platform, lahat sila pare-parehas yung kanilang pangilalim. So, in a good way, you can actually find parts for the Brio na galing sa Jazz. You can mix and match parts for them, and this is actually their iteration. So, sa mga hindi nakakaalam, the outgoing Jazz na hatchback is now discontinued, and this is probably the replacement together with the new Honda City hatchback. So, yeah, gone is the Jazz, and now we have the Brio. And honestly, para sa akin, mas pogi yung Brio tingnan sa side profile niya. Kasi meron siyang winglet and everything, ducktail rather. And of course, we have a Brio here na bags lang to the floor, and you'll see how to bag your Honda Brio. Before that, please like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon for the notification. So ngayon, sa part ng video na ito, hihiramin ko ang inyong mga atensyon. Lend me your ears as well as we discuss the front, rear, and the back side of the car on how to bag the Honda Brio. So I'll see you on that part, and then of course, pakinggan nyo mabuti. Okay, hello and welcome to the front suspension of the Honda Brio. Straight to the point tayo, this is actually a very, very similar suspension. It is actually same as the City, the Jazz, the Mobilio. They share a similar architecture kasi it's a Honda, and they do that most of the time for all of their economical cars or compact sedans and so to speak. So ngayon, we're using a different type of baggy here. It's actually called our semi-slims. It is as slim as a super slim pero as tall as a standard slim bag. So ngayon, this is very good for very light cars kasi not only it will give you more space to work with. Look at my hand. I can literally move it around. So sobrang luwag niya. You can actually fit in very very wide wheels na rin, 8.5s for this car. Pwede na. Ngayon, something to take note is that it is actually a stock suspension. So kita niyo naman, hindi siya coilovers, wala siyang adjustable na height here. Okay, it's actually a stock suspension na tinaas namin yung baso. We removed the welds. We raised up the shock, okay? We raised up this and dropped the shock so we can have a lower drop pag air out ng kotse. Converted it to a air spring flange instead of a coil spring flange. So, yeah. McPherson type strut ang mga gantong kotse. Most economical cars ay McPherson talaga. So, ang disadvantage nun is when you turn the steering wheel, the whole thing rotates on this axis, okay? The fittings will actually rotate. So, that's why the fitting is on the bottom side. Kasi pag nandito, mas malaki yung movement ng circle. The smaller the circle or diameter ng pinaglagyan mo, the better. Okay? So, basic knowledge lang yun. The hose lines went here along the stock brake lines kasi that will give you the OEM slack na kailangan mo. Looking up there, wala naman tayo masyadong kailangan tandaan. Just have to look at the new bag na ginagamit namin for compact cars. So, yeah. Other than that, that's pretty much it. Wala naman tayong kailangan pang sabihin sa unahan ng kotseng to. And that is the summary of the front side of the Brio. Alright, welcome to the rear suspension of the Honda Brio where we are actually meted by another very, very familiar design. Same sila ng subframe design ng ating Honda City. So, of course, if it's the same ng mga yon, this is actually a divorced spring layout. The shocks is here. Okay, and the spring dati nandito, which is now an airbag. And on the back side, we are using our super slims. Super slims being, siya na ang pinaka-slimmest. Okay, slimmest bag that we have for this compact car so we don't have to make palo dito. No? Napaka-konyo, pero that's the proper way to tell you that. Okay, kasi pinapalo pa namin to dati, itong part na to. I don't know if you can see it, pero on this side, yan bakal na yan. Pinapalo pa namin dati yan pag malaki yung bag. Sabi ko, ayoko nun, ang dumi nun. So why not just change the bag to something better? And lo and behold, we have the Super Slims. The Super Slims are very, very sturdy bags. They don't bend or buckle like a sleeve bag, pero they can hold up its shape very nicely. It can lift up cars like a compact car, And these bags are actually used for Ferraris. Did you know that? Hindi nyo alam yun. So, yeah. If you check our Ferrari here na build, you'll actually see na ito rin yung bag na ginagamit namin for that. So you could say the compact cars are using supercar bags, di ba? So yun. That being said, wala naman tayong kailangan tandaan. Since we are using a super, super slim bag, all the clearances are super, super nice. So wala naman tayong kailangan pa i-discuss. Pretty straightforward. Okay? We won't get into details kung paano namin minount ito, na bag na ito. That's for you to find out. And if you want our quality, magpa-airsus kayo sa Fitment Engineering. Okay? Shout out sa team ko. Salamat sa inyo for working so clean for this build. So ngayon, let's move on to the backside of the car and where we will find the system layout. Okay, hello and welcome to the rear side of the Honda Brio. Obviously, ang Brio ay hatchback. So ito yung hatch niya. Wala siyang trunk layout. And something you need to know is that yung Brio ito ay mas maliit pa sa Jazz. So yung spare tire area niya, mas maliit pa dun sa mga standard naming sa ibang kotse. So we can't put the tank compressors underneath. So walang choice itong may-aring ito, kundi mag-top layout. Okay? Anong disadvantage niyan? Of course, space will be taken up. And of course, it will be hella noisy talaga. Something you need to know. Kasi talagang wala kami magagawa. Hatchback yan eh. The driver's right there. The tank compressor is right here. So with the Gentry naman, he can, you know, turn off the compressor if may call siya. So that's the feature na meron yung aming bagong generation. Gentry, okay? Third generation. So ngayon, he's rocking a 4-gallon tank to actually. Kasi gusto kong ma-take up yung space para maganda, para presentable. And then this is actually sporting a single compressor setup. Kasi magaan lang naman yung kotse, hindi mo na kailangan ng dual compressors. And as I said kanina, Gentry module, all of that good stuff packed in there, and that's it. That's the layout. Pretty simple in terms of space. Yun nga sabi ko kanina, compromise talaga tayo. Pero hey, pogi naman yung kotse niya, di ba? So he has that going for him. Ngayon, let's actually drop the car. Let's discuss the outro of this video. And let's see. Alam ko masyadong anticipated tong kotse to. Madaming may gustong abangan tong video na to. So let's talk about how the Brio is actually a great stance platforms. Alright, welcome to the outer of the car. As you can see, nakababa na yung kotse sa lupa. Again, we did our final checks. Pinakita namin yung unahan, yung likod ng kotse. And of course, sa unahan ng kotse is very simple. McPherson type strut. Summary lang to. Maluwag. Nakita nyo yung bagong bag na ginamit namin. Sinagad na naman yung taas baso. We're going to discuss the drop in a bit. Sa likod naman, divorce suspension. Very similar sa Honda City yung subframe. So, using another bag as well para hindi na kailangan paluin yung mga gilid-gilid. If you want to watch the comparison video or if you want to compare kung ano yung ginawa namin dati, the first video ng So You Want to Bag Your Car is actually a Honda Jazz GK. So, watch that video here. Makita nyo yung ginamit naming bags doon laban dito. This is actually non-invasive version of that. Hindi mo na kailangan paluin. Initan yung mga pang-ilalim. So, this is like the most plug-and-play as we can get for this type of cars. Okay? So, ngayon, let's discuss the drop of the car. Of course, I know you want to know yung tindig ng kotse. First of all, let's start sa front. Sa unahan, nagbigay na namin yung pwede namin ibigay sa front side. Pero, limitation to ng tires niya at saka ng stock suspension niya. Kulang pa tayo ng isang daliri. Or in my terms, 15 millimeters of drop. Kaso sagad na yung axle sa kanyang shocks. We can go lower with a coilover. Mas short strut kasi ang coilover and we can drop the car even lower. Pero for now, the client doesn't want to directly dive into it. Siyempre, binabiyahe din niya ng Bicol. So, dun muna tayo sa stock. Gulpihin niya muna yung stock suspension and then of course, palitan natin ang coilovers once he is mentally ready for full stance. Ngayon, sa likod naman, going to the backside, fender tulip naman tayo sa likod. Medyo bago pa yung bags. It will actually go lower after the bags has settled. So ngayon, happy naman ako sa drop ng kotse. This is actually really, really pogi. 16x7, offset 45, 195/45 series na 16. So take note, 16 yun, quite rare. Mahirap ang goma, mahirap yung size ng wheel. So shout out to the owner kasi bagay na bagay ang 16s dito. I wouldn't say 15s is better. 16s para sa akin is a sweet spot for the Jazz and the Brio. And of course, kung yan ay naka-airsus, paano naman yung lift niya? And let's see. Okay. This is actually at 75 PSI. Medyo hindi namin napuno yung main tank. Pero as we talk, we can lift the car up even more. doable naman yung kanyang lift capabilities, mataas naman yung pwedeng ibigay ng kotse kasi stock suspension siya. So let's give it a bit of time bago natin siya i-fully raised up and let's drop it later. So ngayon, the new bags na nilagay namin is actually for compact cars only. So mas maliliit siya, mas sexy yung itsura niya, and of course, that comes with a compromise. Hindi mo siya pwedeng gamitin sa mga mabibigat ang kotse kasi yes, pang compact cars lang siya. Ang benefit niya sa mga gantong kotse is hindi mo na kailangang walwalin yung mga pangilalim ng mga gantong kotse just to fit in a big bag, okay? I discussed that kanina if you wanna rewind. But for now, let's actually race. So ito na yung maximum travel ng unahan. Around 4 fingers, masikip na 4 fingers, 3.5 to 4 fingers lift. Okay? Sa likod naman, we have around 3 fingers sakto. The rear fenders are actually smaller than the front fenders. So that is normal. Okay? Dropping the car, lahat sa remote lang yan, I mean the phone. Okay naman, smooth naman yung transition niya going down. May konting rub lang sa front fenders kasi nga, ito na yung pinaka-manipis na gomang pwede namin makita. Okay, that being said, that is how to bag your Honda Brio RS. And is the Brio a good stance platform? Actually, yeah, not only a stance platform, could be a great track car as well. I started with a similar car, the Honda City for track. Can do a track build as well sa gantong kotse. I like the setup niya, stance pero sporty look. So something fresh sa stance community, Brio na naka-bags. And of course, that is going to be it. I want to talk more about this car, pero sadly, we don't have enough time. It's already around 6 minutes of me talking, so that's going to be it for now. And before everything else, please like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon for the notification. And that's going to be it. Sadly, that is the end of the video. Maraming salamat sa mga nakinig. And I hope if you have a Brio, Jazz, or City, this is the same one for you. So you can actually use this as a reference for your car as well. So, how was it? Okay, it's been Kyle from Fitment Engineering and you're watching Fitment TV. And I'll see you on the next one. Maraming salamat for watching.